Netflix, home training, kiosk, online classes, and much more. These are just a small portion of what we are experiencing from digital transformation. Digital transformation is no longer an idea only in fiction novels, nor it is an event that will happen in further future. We are directly experiencing it on a daily basis as the digital generation. Regardless of the field, this new wave of technology is changing the foundation of our lives. Leisure is one of the fields rapidly changing its form as digital transformation is taking place. Leisure has always taken a big portion of one's life. Thus, the overall change of a society due to digital transformation will obviously impact the way we enjoy leisure. Ultimately, this will lead us to the idea of a change in leisure demands and markets, bringing up several questions. How are leisure businesses changing? What contents are in demand? And as consumers of the new digitally transformed market, what is our duty?
Regardless of the era, it is undeniable that leisure takes up a big portion in one's life. The era of the leisure economy has arrived, as the desire to use leisure meaningfully increased, along with the improvement of an overall quality of life. The domestic market for leisure services has doubled from 2010 to about 53 trillion won in 2018, and the proportion of household spending on leisure has also increased, indicating that investment in quality living is increasing. Outdoor supplies market is an example that indicates the growth in the leisure market. In the 2000s, many people were climbing and walking as their hobby, thus the outdoor supplies markets began to gain vitality. In 2008, the growth rate of production of hiking shoes and tents reached 71.46% higher compared to the previous year. This increased demand for leisure creates new consumption and investment, and in the future, the leisure service industry is expected to catalyze the growth of more companies.
The concept of digital medium has emerged in recent years. Digital medium can simply be thought of as a bridge between leisure consumers and leisure activities. The advent of digital media soon led to the commercialization of today's digital leisure. Digital integration represents this. It refers to a new form of integration product that combines all information and communication technology in just one device, like smartphones. The desire to put the maximum amount of information into the least space could be fulfilled by technology advances brought about by the fourth industrial revolution. And digital integration can be in the hands of users in the form of various IT devices. Now, leisure consumers enjoy digital leisure, spending time on more diverse content and interacting with the world without physical activity. This digital leisure is meaningful in that it can pursue pleasure and happiness, which is the essence of leisure, away from physical and spatial constraints.
COVID-related regulations have greatly restricted traditional leisure life, shifting consumers to digital leisure markets that can be enjoyed indoors. As sports facilities such as fitness centers were banned, the online fitness market, including Samsung Health, grew by 72% compared to before the pandemic. Also, the demand for home chef kits and delivery platform services exploded as customers felt hesitant about using restaurants. As the pandemic situation has been continued for more than a year, digital leisure has solidified a new lifestyle for people around the world.
OTT service, or over-the-top service, refers to media services directly offered to viewers by means of the internet. It is not only just a field invigorated by digital transformation, but it is also a good example that shows the rapid growth of OTT services in the media field. Netflix is the leading brand of OTT services. According to Statista 2017, the number of Netflix users in the United States has overtaken the number of cable TV users. Then what feature makes OTT service so different that makes people be obsessed over it? The answer can be found in the technology input. The rapid growth of OTT service is achieved by investing progressive technologies that can improve personalized and customized service for users. These factors are significantly driving the product demand, which is accelerating the growth of the market. According to Allied Market Research, in 2019, the global OTT market size was valued at $121 billion, and it is expected to reach about $1,039 billion by 2027.
The digital fitness market has been steadily growing since the mid-2010s due to improved various digital technologies and higher quality platforms. The leaders in the digital fitness market is Peloton, a customized exercise service company thought to be the Netflix of the home training industry. Peloton combines exercise equipment and exercise video content, allowing users to follow professional trainers' lectures through tablets or smartphones. AR glass Ghost Pacer with augmented reality technology is also noteworthy. The chronic problem of home training lies in relative boredom and motivation, which can be addressed by running with a virtual running mate via augmented reality technology. With COVID-19 prolonged, the desire to enjoy a variety of high-quality dishes at home has increased, thus increasing demand. This means that the home chef trend, which is different from the existing household food consumption, is spreading. In response to this trend, cooking utensils and online services that increase convenience via digital technology are becoming more popular. Samsung's artificial intelligence-based cooking service, SmartThings Cooking, automatically sends ingredients purchased through its application, as well as cooking modes, times, and temperature to Samsung Smart Oven to manage the entire cooking process. Users can conveniently taste high-quality food in their personal kitchens by reducing the risk of cooking failure. And the companies can create a stable profit structure by integrating cooking-related consumption from ingredients to cooking utensils.
Leisure industries such as digital fitness and home cooking have benefited from digital transformation and the pandemic. If the pandemic gradually ends and everyone returns to daily life, it is possible that traditional leisure life will become popular again. For companies to overcome this future challenge, it is necessary to efficiently utilize unprecedented surpluses gained during the pandemic. If businesses actively invest in new technologies and continue to disseminate new content, and ultimately seek to harmonize online and offline leisure, companies will be able to continue their growth by forming a stable consumer base. A prime example is Netflix's production of original series. Netflix, which used to only distribute existing content, has implemented a strategy to ensure success in the future of digital leisure, monopolizing its original content. The company has strengthened its strategy by investing a massive amount of capital in their original content. Netflix's strategy is significant in that it not only attracts new subscribers, but also prevents existing subscribers from leaving in the long run. On the other hand, there are leisure industries that have sustained losses because of digital transformation and the pandemic. Most companies that produce products that require face-to-face contact or mostly consumed offline are having difficulties. For these companies to overcome the problem and turn the current crisis into an opportunity, they need to cooperate with companies that produce digital media or online leisure content. And they also need to utilize existing expertise with new manufacturers in order to keep up in the era of fourth industrial revolution. Sony is a great example of a company that has overcome the crisis and reached its peak with bold reforms and innovations. Sony, which had been on a roll with the success of the portable cassette player Walkman, failed to keep up with Apple's emergence and excessive business diversification, recording a deficit of 460 billion yen. However, Sony has recently adopted a new strategy of choice and concentration, aiming for a rebound. Sony reduced the proportions of manufacturing industries like chemical businesses, PC and TV businesses, and audio businesses, which have brought Sony prosperity. Instead, it will now focus on digital service industries, such as games, music, and movies. By maximizing and focusing on its strengths like this, Sony is pushing the envelope. Digital leisure has many positive functions, but the adverse effects cannot be ignored. Most digital leisure is done over the internet or digital devices. Therefore, it can be used freely anytime, anywhere. This has led to digital leisure addiction. The percentage of smartphone addiction in Korea in 2020 increased to 23.3%, indicating that the consequences of digital leisure should not be taken lightly. Now that the digital transformation is currently underway, the solution to overcome the adverse effects is educational leisure and the integration of offline leisure and digital leisure. Leisure education in particular focuses on the net and adverse functions of digital leisure, so that leisure can be used more productively as a means to achieve happiness. And screen, baseball, and golf are examples of the combination of offline and online leisure. They are significant in that they not only serve the addition to digital leisure, but also the success of both offline and digital leisure.
Leisure, which has had a huge impact on human life so far, has taken a new turn with digital transformation and COVID-19. Now that a new category of digital leisure has emerged, companies are using creative innovation to harmonize online and offline services and generate sustainable profits. In a modern society with rapid technological innovation and social change, what form will the next leisure market take?